Cyrus, congratulations on your new novel.
Thank you.
Absolutely fantastic that we now will very soon have a Chronicle of a Corpse Bearer, which will be added to the list of your marvelous plays and your work in fiction. So I just wanted to begin by asking you how it was that you approached this very unusual subject. And your protagonist, the wonderfully named Feroz Elchida, is someone who deliberately drops out of his class and privilege and adopts a marginal life. So do you want to talk a little bit about how this character came to you?
Actually, the germ of the idea was lost in my, as it were, subconscious at least 20 years ago while I was doing research for a documentary on the lives of the khandhia. I thought, you know, that I had thought that here was a novel which will have universal appeal, because the theme was about man's cruelty to man, as you see it in a big city like Bombay. And as it shows in the riots which took place in the 90s and so on. But in spite of that, the book was completely lost in the course of the year. Nobody noticed it, nobody, hardly anyone read it except the few friends I had. Or, you know, even strangers read it and liked it, but those who read it only happened across it. So I thought, now let me, for my next book, almost in reaction, I said, let me choose a subject which is so miniature and sort of microscopic that, and yet has some sort of universal themes which can appeal to everyone. But it should be something that hardly anyone is aware of, you know, but the, I mean, the scope of the thing. You know? And suddenly this story I heard in 1991 came back to me. And I, of course, completely changed it and adapted the idea to a new kind of storyline. But the idea was basically that somebody had forced a person to marry into the khandhia community as a form of vendetta.
Right.
You know, against the family of what he married. So I, of course, turned it around and made him into a person from the priestly class.
Right.
And so on.
There's a sense of incredible inevitability where small decisions set off consequences that determine the entire lives of people in terms of this. But you also chose to set the book, the main events, in the 1940s. So to coincide more or less with the Quit India movement and all of that political turmoil.
Yes, that. That's again because my starting point was actually, even though the Quit India movement was 1942, this story, possibly apocryphal, which I heard from the son of Ranjit, was, he said the strike happened in 1941.
Right.
And I thought I could, you know, set it around that time. And then everything developed from there, you see. I guess the best part about writing, and this is more, perhaps only part for me which is pleasurable, is the fact that it happens while you're doing it. And real writing, I think, happens in the course of, you know, you move from one work to the next, one sentence to the next, one paragraph to the next. And so really the story developed as I was writing. It is purely fiction, even though it's started from this kind of
which is actually oral history, because when you went into your research, you did not find any.
That's right. I tried at first to visit the panchayat offices and look for any records of this event, the strike of khandhia which took place in 1941. No one had ever heard of it, nor was there any kind of information on it. And then I bought a copy of this history of the Parsi panchayat by
which suggests another whole line of thinking about the book. Your characters have wonderful names. How did you happen upon the protagonist's name, Elchi Banner?
Well, to be frank, I mean, I came across it just by chance in this same history of the Parsi panchayat, which has innumerable Parsi names in it, in the context of names of functionaries or authorities in the history of the panchayat, or even, I think, places bars and donors who, and donors for the Tower of Silence. So one of these names happened to me. This struck me as a wonderful name to keep because it has sort of a very ancient ring about it. It's no longer in use, I suppose. Right. I haven't come across anyone else with that name. And it's sort of quaint, it's special.
Cyrus, thank you so much for this conversation.
Thank you.
It's been a real pleasure discussing with you.